Philippine lawmakers studying possible ways to ensure Filipino seafarers' safety. House Overseas Workers Affairs Panel Chair Jude Asidre says he's eyeing a measure to ban Filipino seafarers from sailing into the Red Sea. But the lawmaker says he's still factoring the risks involved, as well as provisions in the Magna Carta for Filipino seafarers. In February, the Migrant Workers Department issued an advisory declaring the Red Sea as a warlike and high-risk area. Seafarers are given the right to refuse sailing to such areas and are entitled to receive double compensation should they agree to go.
Well, we'll have to get all information needed, no? Malaking bagay dyan ang magiging papel ng Magna Carta of Seafarers para mapangalagaan at ma-insure ang security nila. At how will this be included in factored in sa mga kontrata ng ating mga seafarers, lalo-lalo na yung nadideploy sa parting yan.
Meanwhile, House Speaker Martin Romualdez has given out 150,000 pesos in cash assistance to each of the 21 Filipino seafarers rescued from MV Tudor. The former head of the Philippine Technology and Research Center pushes back on claims he was involved in illegal offshore gaming operations in Central Luzon. Victoria Tula now on the line for the details. Victoria?
Ron, a former government official found guilty in the Priority Development Assistance Fund, or PDAF scam, could possibly be linked to the illegal Philippine offshore gaming operators in Bamban, Tarlac and Porac, Pampanga, as documents from the Senate Committee on Women, Children, Family Relations and Gender Equality show. The documents provided by the Senate Committee to the media are letters addressed to former Philippine Amusement and Gaming Corporation Chairman and CEO Andrea Domingo. In the letter dated September 10, 2020, the sender named Thelma Barago Laranan identified herself and former Technology and Resource Center Director General Dennis Cunanan as representatives of Hongsheng Gaming Technology Incorporated, located in Bamban. In a letter dated October 20, 2020, Cunanan himself wrote Domingo a letter saying he was a representative of Lucky South 99 Limited Company. Lucky South 99 is the illegal pogo recently raided in Porac. In 2023, the Sandigan Bayan handed down guilty verdict against Cunanan over some PDAF cases, such as the alleged misuse of the PDAF of the late Negros Oriental 3rd District Representative Herminio Teves. Senator Riz Ontiveros, chairperson of the committee, sounded the alarm over the possible link of Cunanan to the illegal pogos. She adds Cunanan will be invited to the next Senate hearing on pogos. The former TLRC executive, meanwhile, has responded to the allegation being hurled against him. Cunanan said when they were contracted as an independent consultant to help Lucky South 99 to register in the country, everything was legally undertaken. He explained back then no illegal actions were associated to the company, adding they would never have engaged with the firm if these derogatory records have come to light at that time. He also insists he is no longer connected to the companies and his conscience is clear regarding this matter. Ron?
Victoria Tulan with that report. Thanks. The provincial government of Pampanga investigating the lapses of the Porac local government and utilities firms in the operation of a massive illegal offshore gaming hub. Pampanga Vice Governor Lilia Pineda tells Teleradio Serbisyo Lucky South 99 was operating without a business license as well as building and electrical permits. She also wants Apogo's power and internet providers to explain how the compound was serviced despite lacking these permits. Pineda adds the findings of Lucky South 99's administrative and criminal liabilities will likely lead to its total closure.
Walang report sa planning officer, sa planning department, wala silang report dun sa building permit, sa electrical permit, wala, lahat sila zero. Para silang pumasok na wala silang pakialam, wala silang respeto sa gobyerno.
Eh,
parang wala, ayaw nila yung policy ng gobyerno, pati yung LGU.